My name is Tom Rothrock. I'm co-CEO of Infotech, and I've been with Infotech since 1981. I originally got started as a professor of economics at the University of Wisconsin and also at the University of Florida, and did a lot of work in analyzing bidding behavior of contractors in seal bid markets. And that's what led me to work with the Florida Attorney General's Office in the early 80s on a major investigation of the highway construction industry. We developed a lot of good analytical tools that other agencies became interested in because at the time there was challenges throughout the entire country of investigations for bid rigging behavior. We were requested to provide the tools that we developed in Florida to other agencies. And that sort of got us started working with the states. Kansas was the first in 1982 to utilize these techniques, and then it grew from there. Nearly 40 agencies using BAM's DSS. The data used by Project Data Analytics will be extracted from the underlying production database, which will reside within the state agency's environment. But the extraction takes just a matter of minutes from the production database. It's compressed and uploaded to the cloud in a matter of seconds, so that it really gives users access to real-time production data. Project Data Analytics will really expand on the capabilities that currently exist in BAM's DSS. Certainly the ease of use is one of the biggest factors, because we anticipate that a broader range of users, including executive managers, will be able to directly access information. Project Data Analytics will also contain many graphical displays of the information, which will make the information in the database easy to understand. And it will also include executive dashboards, so that executives or others can directly interact with data to refine and dig down into the information in greater detail.
What we're looking for in Ohio, the availability to use the data analytics portion, is the fact that now that AASHTOWare Project is a unified database, I'll be able to pull information from the pre-construction area, the civil rights and labor area, construction, materials, estimation. It'll be able to give me contract information all across from cradle to grave, but I'll be able to provide my leadership with dashboard functionality. So if they wanted to see a contract and where it's at, either in the process of being built or maybe change order modifications where we are as a district, as an agency as a whole, or drill down all the way to a project, that they have that availability.
AASHTOWare Project provides so much information within its database that allows us to do so many things to improve our processes within the department. Currently, our unbalancing situation is that if we can prove that at bid opening that the low bidder as red is not the true low bidder because there are changes in quantity, we can throw out that bid as being materially unbalanced and award to a contractor that bid responsibly. We have concerns that some bidders may be bidding with anticipation of change orders when they go to the construction process. They may bid low on an item of work, knowing that that work is going to be non-performed or a portion of it will be. They put the money in another area of the bid that they know they will get paid for, and so they keep money in the contract even though an item may be non-performed. The team's greatest success resulted in an $11.5 million settlement with road salt suppliers. These road salt suppliers supplied salt for our snow and ice removal during the winter months. The team populated 5 years worth of bid data into our BAM's DSS software. With that software, we were able to use the models in BAM's DSS to establish market areas and examine bidding patterns. The results turned over to the Attorney General, and a lawsuit was brought to the companies. It alleged that they had agreed to divide the market, not to compete, and raise the prices for the areas that they were selling salt. Ultimately, this resulted in that $11.5 million settlement.
From my perspective, because I work with the Civil Rights and Labor Management Group, I will be trying to focus on trying to get some support to basically use data analytics to look for maybe possible fraud within payrolls.
Data analytics is the first introduction for AASHTOware Project into the software as a service deployment method.
Tremendous advantages come with that in that, for one, all users will be using the same version of the software, the current version, at all times, so that agencies won't get behind in updating software to the current standard. The system will be accessible anywhere that you have an internet access and a browser and proper authorization. And it will work on multiple platforms. So it can work on laptops, desktops, tablets, as well as phones. So that if you're out in the field and need to look up some information or utilize data analytics, you can do so right at the job site. You don't have to be back in the agency at your desktop.
Software as a service will allow the task force to get functionality in the hands of the users much, much faster. Data analytics will help the task force by reducing the overhead costs with supporting and maintaining multiple versions of software, since everybody will be using the same version.
The AASHTOware Project Data Analytics software provides a revolutionary way agencies leverage their AASHTOware Project data, helps drive business decisions, and creates added value. With all this valuable data in one place and accessible anytime, anywhere, the software fills a key role aiding in making more informed and quicker data-driven decisions.
AASHTOware Project is already a robust enterprise-wide software solution which significantly increases efficiency and productivity for transportation agencies nationwide. I'm extremely excited with the addition of the data analytics software as a service, as it will provide tremendous additional business value to this already outstanding set of tools.